Google Keep for grading papers. Yes, it's a real thing. Sometimes I'm stuck here in the home office in Grand Rapids, Michigan, and I might be grading papers all weekend long while students are merrily prancing off in Daytona Beach. It's April 2017 right now, and they might just be doing that. I don't know. One time I was stuck here in the office grading papers all weekend while my boyfriend was off at the Super Bowl. How fun is that? Well, today I can use Google Keep to make the process go much faster, the grading process go much faster. And I use it in conjunction with Google Docs. And I want to show you really quickly how I do it. So I'm going to step behind my desk and show you how I use Google Keep in conjunction with Google Docs to make the grading process for papers go so much quicker. Here we are in Google Keep, and one of the first tasks I will do is brainstorm two different lists. I'll brainstorm a list called Green Flag and one called Red Flag. I'll even give them a color just because it's fun and because it'll make it a little easy for me later on down the road. If you don't know how to do it, all you have to do is go down to the bottom of your list and make it any color that you wish. I want this to be called Green Flag, so I'm going to make it a green list. And I'll either brainstorm, because I've been down this road before, a list of comments that I generally tend to put on student papers as I grade them. The great comments, maybe some will be familiar to you, things like great headline, strong start, specific and concrete examples, terrific, and some of the things that are red flags that you said that you would gig the students for, or that is on your rubric of this is what I don't want to see on the paper. Awkward phrasing, passive voice, run-on sentences, unclear, weak verbs. So brainstorm your list of comments that you generally tend to say. And the next thing you'll want to do is go to your Google Drive and go to Google Documents, where you have a shared folder with your students, and perhaps you tell them to put in their assignments every single week, their papers. Let's go to the first week and take a look at the first weeks of assignment. And we see that there's a whole lot of papers here. Let's take a look at the Honesty Room. I'll click on that. And here we are in the Honesty Room. I'm using this as an example. And I want to start grading and making comments on this paper. So what we do often is go to Insert and then click on Comment. And this is where I might start adding comments on how I feel about this title. But before I do that, what I'm going to do is click on Tools and also keep Notepad. I'm going to click on that and watch what happens. The Keep Notepad that I created with my comments will pop right up. That way, as I start going through stacks and stacks of student papers, like maybe 20 or 30 in a weekend, I can go directly to my rubrics, do a select, and then I'll hit Control C for copy and Control V for paste. And of course that's Command C and Command V if you're using an Apple device, and hit comment. I can continue reading, add different comments as I go through whatever it is that I'm grading. Let's add another comment really quickly. And say I'm grading away and I see something else and I feel that I need to add something else to my rubric, or I find that I'm using another comment frequently, I can add it right here. I don't have to go back to Google Keep. I can just keep this running list of comments here and keep reading my big group of papers and keep a reminder list here, and also use it to cut and copy and paste my comments throughout the student documents. Let me know in the comments what you think of this approach. Remember to hit subscribe and we'll continue the conversation later. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening.